Okay guys, so welcome back to our 39th PHP and MySQL video tutorial. This is the second part of our insertion query. So here we are. We have already typed our query and let's see a final look at our query. Include connection, this should space connection.php, insert into user, I think. So there is S missing here. Let me verify the name of our table. Users, so it is S users. Then we specify two field names, value Ali and BSC. And we are, you know, if MySQL underscore query con and the connection variable here, the Q1. Remember, this con variable will not work if you do not include the connection.php. So, because this variable has been defined in our connection.php file. So, echo insertion successful, then echo unsuccessful in here. So, all these things. Let's save this one and let's click on users. And remember, you are in browse, so here you can see there is no value already in our this table. So we'll just go to our PHP file. Remember to save your file before and just refresh your file. Here you can see saying that connection established, insertion successful. Now let's refresh this PHP and my admin panel F5 and it will show the data that we have just inserted. So here you can see Ali and BSC. So these Ali has been inserted in our name and class, in class BSC has been inserted. Remember the order which we give the field names and the value should be same. So Ali will go in name and BSC has gone in the class. So now we'll just go with another, I would say Saad. And instead of BSC, I will say MSC. Let's save this one. Just go to our file and just refresh it, and the insertion has been done. So now let's refresh our PHP my admin panel. So, and here, Saad and my MSC has been inserted here. So this is the way that you can insert the value. But in case if you want to use some variable here, you can just simply create two variables. I will say v1 and v2, just simple as that. So now we can use those variable here instead of the values $v1 and $v2. Okay, so now we have variables here. Now we can give values, some value here in single quote or double quote, whatever you guys want. In this case, I want to give some value here for Johnson, for example, and the name of the class, the Johnson, is BTech, for example. So now let's save this one. Let's see, will it work with the variables? Refresh it, insertion successful. Now let's refresh this one as well and our data should appear. So Johnson and BTech has been inserted successfully. So this is the way that we can use the insertion query. We can also create a form as well and do that, which we'll do in our later tutorial, to insert the use the insertion query with the form as well. So if you have any question regarding this tutorial, you are welcome to ask. You can just leave a comment below this video and I will definitely reach up to your question and answer it. Remember the order that you have given the field names and the values and the name of the table should be, you know, should be accurate. Do not miss any alphabet or it will show the error. So you are welcome to ask any question if you have any. But if you like this video, please hit the like button. But if you don't, then in the comments please tell us why you do not like and how we can improve our videos so that you can like them. So take care of yourself guys and goodbye. Follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Google+. Visit our website www.sartreviews.com and then go to learn section from menu. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to learn more.